Russia, under the leadership of Vladimir Putin, is trying to make sure that no loose ends remain in the neighborhood. In the process, it has identified the need to consolidate the region of the Far East as well as increase its influence in the Korean Peninsula. Russia has decided to utilize the soft power influence of Mongolia in the Korean Peninsula. Mongolia has for a long time fostered good relations with the two Koreas, and if utilized as a channel by Russia, it can help decrease the influence of China in the region. The increased investment of Russia in Mongolia and its laid-back approach via North Korea are living proofs of the same. Hi, and welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host Shubhangi, and in this video, I will tell you how Russia, with Mongolia's help, is ready to kick China out of the Korean Peninsula. Let's begin. The importance of Asia's Far East is only going to increase with the increased navigability of the Arctic Ocean. This is something Russia understands very well. Russia realizes that China is also interested in gaining influence in the region, and thus it is taking some preemptive steps. Russia has a need to expand its influence in the entire Northeast of Asia in general, and the Korean Peninsula in particular. In its efforts to do the same, Moscow, with Mongolian assistance, is going to kick China out of the Korean Peninsula. In its efforts to consolidate the region, Putin is hitting back at Xi Jinping and liberating Mongolia little by little. Sandwiched between Russia in the north and China in the south, Mongolia could soon serve as an important transit country for Russian natural gas and its related supply chains, and its soft power diplomacy via the Korean Peninsula can be of great utility to Russia. The examples of infrastructure projects can be an obvious confirmation of the same. When finished, the Soyuz Vostok gas pipeline will connect Russia's power of Siberia too with Mongolian territory. Since the days of acting as a mediator during the Korean War, Mongolia has acquired the trust of North Korea. Despite Mongolia's move to democratic administration and a liberalized economy, the two countries' historic relations, which date back to 1948 and are founded on the shared communist ideology, have remained strong. Mongolia might serve as a window to the outside world for North Korea, allowing it to learn from its experience and grow economically. On the other hand, Mongolia has also maintained close ties with South Korea since the two countries established diplomatic relations in 1990. Relations with Seoul have expanded into comprehensive collaborations in numerous domains, including politics, economics, and culture, as part of Ulaanbaatar's third neighbor policy. Politically, the two countries have attempted to increase diplomatic cooperation by convening an annual ministerial meeting to discuss foreign policy issues, including Mongolia's support for the Korean Peninsula's peace process. Russia wants to utilize Mongolia's goodwill to increase its influence in the Korean Peninsula. By doing so, it also wants to keep a check over the ever-increasing size of China in the region, which can be a problem going ahead. The Chinese ruled Mongolia during the era of the Qing dynasty, but recognized their independence in 1946. Since then, despite being independent, it has been heavily dependent on China for its trade and commerce. The nation seems like another province of China, whose central authority keeps using its diktat on the former's government. However, now Russia is trying to bring the country out of the shackles of Chinese influence and geographical dependence. Mongolia's diplomatic achievements have shown how small governments can leverage soft power to increase their foreign policy clout. Mongolia's soft diplomatic mediation efforts have helped to thaw a frozen relation, particularly with North Korea, and have opened the way to peace. Mongolia has quietly worked to resurrect the Korean Peninsula's sagging security conversation, strengthening regional cooperation, and raising Mongolia's status as a foreign policy player in the process. It is this soft power-fueled potential of Mongolia which Russia wants to utilize and make sure that it can somehow expand its influence in the Korean Peninsula and at the same time kick China out. Russia's regional interests include a desire for the Korean Peninsula to remain open to economic opportunities for the sake of growing the Russian Far East, as well as a desire to maintain the status quo in North Korea. Russia wants to make sure that its interests are not jeopardized by China, and realizing this, it wants to use Mongolian assistance to kick China out of the Korean Peninsula.